I'd like to start off with the building and construction sector. Esau Frankie with results out this week that weren't all that bad considering the pressure that the construction sector has come under of late. What did you make of those results?
I thought they were a very good set of results. As you say, given how badly the construction sector, particularly the large companies, you know, the Murrays and the Avengers and the impacts that this latest environment's had on their results, Esau actually showed up a strong set of results, more conservative. You know, they clearly managed the business well over this period of time. They come across well in terms of the way, you know the forward-looking statements that they make. Order books looking relatively strong. It's flat year on year, but a good set of results. Nice conservative growth in earnings.
And the acquisitions that were consolidated into the business this year, particularly in the civils arena, that strategy to diversify has clearly paid off for the company. Can you take us through your thoughts on that strategy?
Sure. Well, I think you've got to understand that Esau listed and they were purely what they call a geotechnical business, which is kind of piling and pipe jacking and that sort of thing. It's very technical work. And then they went and bought their bigger competitor in Frankie. And so now they're the kind of dominant player in that particular area. And I think they realized that they, you know, almost in South Africa, fairly mature business, and they needed to add another leg, or two legs in this case, onto the business. Both niche players, and certainly with hindsight, with the benefit of hindsight, you know, the purchase of the civils business clearly gave them a good kick in the earnings into this period.
You mentioned the order book and you said flat, it's at 1.6 billion rand. In your opinion, what are the prospects for the building and construction sector? Of course, the country is coming out of recession, but the construction sector does lag in the general economy. So what is your opinion on the outlook?
Well, I think you've got to look, there's two things we can look at. One is obviously the prospects for the construction industry as a whole, and then obviously what we look at is the pricing of the listed construction stocks, given what we think of the sector. And as you say, the economy is coming out of the recession. We've yet to see, I mean, we want to see things like employment growth and that increase in real income in the country, because that's what will drive the consumer spend and have all the roll-on effects to the rest of the economy. And then what you'll find is the banking, the financial sector, making finance available again more easily to property developments. And, you know, so as things grow, the construction industry will recover. As we know, government's got a massive pipeline of infrastructure jobs. Part of the problem, and indeed one of the impacts we saw in Esau, was the kind of delay of tenders, and that's been an issue up until now. But hopefully, as we come out of the recession and government kind of gets their act together in terms of putting out those tenders, and we saw Eskom raising cash in the form of a loan, and so there's roll-on benefits from those things, that the actual spend in the construction sector will come back. You know, as you mentioned, Esau's order book, certainly spend hasn't stopped dead. They do have a secured order book, as you said, of 1.6 billion. The prospects are okay in South Africa, I guess. And then, of course, we're at the bottom tip of Africa, and the prospects in Africa on a more conservative basis are also quite good.
At R3.25, do you see value in the stock?
I do, actually. I think it's well priced, or I think it's cheap at the moment. Given the quality of the company, it's gone from being a tiny little company when they first listed to something that's really of meaningful size. It's on, you know, they moved to the main board. They have come onto the radar of other investors out there who wouldn't normally look at much smaller companies, and they've really managed their numbers well. We've seen a good change this year off of last year, and so I think at this price, it's well priced for investment.
Another company on your radar, B&W Instrumentation and Electrical.
Yeah.
What about this company has grabbed your attention?
This one's a much smaller company than Esau. Also very niche. They do kind of very technical jobs. They come in at the end of construction jobs, if you like, and they wire up all the process systems and they test all the equipment and they calibrate all the fancy equipment, and then, you know, they kind of come back and maintain it and they do all those sorts of things. They're in the, obviously in the industrial sector, in mining, they're in oil and gas. They have the capabilities to go into kind of nuclear, you know, power stations, coal-fired power stations. So a very interesting company. There's a good story behind the company. What we've seen since they listed is good growth into Africa. They've worked previously in Africa. They do a lot of work at the moment in Mozambique and in Mauritius, and further north. And so it's a high margin specialist company. They've acquired a small company called Pontins, which does kind of fire protection, and there's a lot of kind of synergies in terms of site setup and those sorts of things. It's quite an exciting company to watch. I think this one's going to go places.
So definitely one to keep the eye on.